Hi friends, welcome to Yuvaguru Maths Theory Lectures. Problems we have already covered in this Yuvaguru Maths Olympiad app. Download it from Google Play Store. It covers theory as well as problems for various boards like CBSC, ICSC and state boards within India and outside India also. So let's start theory of algebraic expressions. Now, algebraic expression is a combination of constants and variables. Means what? This is variable 2x is a x is a variable basically, and 7 is a constant. So it contains 2x plus 7, or it can be a monomial also. We'll see that. So constants and variables. Remember that we use operations like addition, subtraction, etc. to form the algebraic expression. That's okay. Variable does not have a fixed value, means this x can change. Suppose if x is 1, then the value is 2 into 1 plus 7, x is 2 2 into 2 plus 7, x is 3 2 into 3 plus 7. It goes on changing as the variable changes. It is represented by a, y, p, m, etc. Generally it's given by x and y only, because generally we find only two variables, and third is z sometimes. So constant is a fixed value. See this 7, it can't change at all. Any number without a variable is a constant. See here, we have covered this in one of our earlier videos, so that's why we are moving fast in this. See, 2x plus 7 is an algebraic expression. Now also y square is an algebraic expression. See here, what's the difference between 2x plus 7 and y square? See here, in 2x plus 7, the degree, means highest degree of x is 1. In y square, the highest degree of 2 is 2. Highest degree of y is 2. Okay, that's the difference. The degree, this above number is called as degree. For x, there is no above number, so it's 1 always. Okay, move on. Now, what are called as terms of an expression? To form an expression, we use constants and variables and separate them using operations like addition, subtraction, etc. These parts of expressions which we separate using operations are called terms. See here, 4x minus y plus 7. See, these are separated by minus and plus. So these are terms. 4x is a term, y is a term, and 7 is a term. Okay. Remember one basic: it is always separated by plus and minus only, never by multiply and divide. Because if it's multiply and divide, then it becomes a monomial. We'll see that coming further. Now, what are factors of a term? Every term is a product of factors. As in the expression, the term 4x is product of 4 and x. See this. Let's see this 4x. 4x means what? 4 multiply x. So, it's a product of 4 into x. So, what can be the factors of this then? 4 and x. Suppose, let's say I say 6. 6 means what? 2 into 3. So, what can be the factors of 6 then? 2 and 3. Right, what all multiplied together to form that number, those numbers which are multiplied form the factor. It's as simple, right? Okay, we'll find the gist of whatever we have studied up till now. Summary, gist means summary. Expression means these terms separated by plus and minus. See here, AB minus AB is one term, 2B square is one term, 3A square is one term. Now make these terms separate, and then the factors are, see this, minus 1 A and B, here 2 B and B. Here remember there are two factors for B, right? 1 B and second B. Both the factors have to be written, right? Over here also, minus 1, 3 and A square. All are factors. Factors means what? Even if you divide this minus 3 A square with minus 1, then also you get some answer without any remainder. That's the important part. If there's any remainder, then it's not a factor, right? Okay, now what is coefficient and what is variable? See this, 2x plus 4y plus minus 9. This 2 is known as a coefficient, which is a numerical part, that is a coefficient. Now, can this be a coefficient then? 9 is also a numerical part, but this is not a coefficient. Why? Because it is not attached with any variable. See here, 2x is attached with x, 4 is attached with y. Is 9 attached with anyone? No. So, that's why 2x, 2 and 4 are coefficients, but 9 is not a coefficient. 9 is called a constant. X and y are variables. That's okay. That's you have learnt already. Now, like and unlike terms. What are they? Like terms are terms which have same algebraic factors. Now this is something we need to elaborate. Elaborate means give you more briefing on this. So let's elaborate. They must have the same variable with same exponent. Now this is something understandable. Same variable with same exponent means what? Say this: 2x square plus 3x. Okay. Do they have same variable? Consider all first one only. 2x square plus 3x minus 5. Do they have same variable? Yes. Do they have the same exponent? Exponent means this power. Do they have the same power? No. So that's why both the conditions are not satisfied. Same variable, same exponent. So these are not like terms. Now look over here. 2a square plus 3a square plus 7a minus 7. Okay. Now in this 2a square and 3a square, are they like terms? Okay, let's see. Same variable, yes. Same exponent, yes. So like terms. So next, 7a. Is 3a square and 7a like term? Same variable, yes. Same exponent, no. So they are not like terms. So remember this. Like terms means same exponent, same variable, same exponent. This is very important. Okay, then unlike term means what? 2x square and 3x. Okay, unlike terms, agreed. Suppose if in place of x there would have been y, then 2x square plus 3y, are these unlike terms? So again two conditions. Same variable, no. So gone. So these are unlike terms. Okay. Now types of algebraic expressions. Okay, what are these? Monomials. Mono means single, bi means two, tri means three, and poly means many, more than three. Okay. So monomial means what? Any expression having only one term. Now one term means what? See this: 5x square, 7y, 3ab. These all have one term. Now we'll understand this better when we study binomial. Now binomial with two unlike terms. This is important. Two unlike terms. Let's see. Suppose if 5x square plus 2y, are these two terms like? Like means what? Same variable, same exponent. Do they have? No. So these are unlike. Okay. Now if in place of 2y, I write 5x square plus say 3x square. Okay. What happens? 5x square, 3x square. So are they unlike? No. They can be added. Why? Because both are same variable, same exponent. So it can become 5x square plus 3x square becomes 8x square. So it again becomes a monomial. So what is the monomial and what is the binomial? If it is separated by plus or minus, then it becomes a binomial, trinomial, polynomial, whatever it is. But it should be separated by plus and minus only, not by division or multiplication. Okay. So you can't have 5x square plus 3x square over here. These need to be separate, unlike. Okay. Similarly over here, see this: 2ab minus 3b. So not like. That's why they can be kept as separate. Right? Next, trinomial. Any expression with three unlike terms. Now that's simple. 5x square plus 2y plus 9xy. Three terms separated by plus or minus. Similarly over here. Polynomial, same one. You can go on. 5x square plus 2y plus 9xy plus 4. Only the condition is unlike, and basically unlike. They should be separated. Okay? See, this picture clears all your doubts. Monomial. Multiplication in between. Binomial, two terms, unlike terms, separated by plus. Trinomial, three terms, separated by plus. This polynomial, four terms, separated by plus. See this, even this is a polynomial, okay? Even though it doesn't have this variable, but then also it's a polynomial. You can extend it to anything, 4y square over here, then 5xy, xyz or something like that. You can go on and on and on, okay? This theory you might be feeling boring because it's a theory. Problems, you follow the problems in this app, you'll find it interesting. See, a human being likes challenges. Just speaking one way from my side and you are just listening, you'll feel sleepy. Always follow the problems, challenges, okay? Addition and subtraction of algebraic expressions, quite easy one. If you have to add like term, then simply add the numerical coefficient. See this: 2x plus 5x. So xx same. See here, variable same, coefficient same. Numerical coefficient, no. Yeah, variable same. Then exponent same. x raised to 1, then you can add. So it becomes 7x. Suppose if it would have been 2x square plus 5x, variable same, exponent same, no. So not added. Similarly, subtraction, same logic. 11 minus 3 is 8. It should be only like terms, okay? Addition of unlike terms, okay. 9y plus 2x plus 3. Can we add this? No. So keep it as it is. If we have to add unlike terms, then we just have to put add or plus or minus sign in between the terms. You can't do anything else. Just keep it as it is. Similarly, subtraction. So don't waste your time. Same logic. You can't add or subtract this unlike terms. Okay. Addition of a general algebraic expression means basically you get a problem to solve in of this type. So to add a general algebraic expressions, we arrange them so that the like terms come together. Remember this. That's it. And then simplify the terms and unlike blah blah blah. That's okay. Like terms come together. This is very important. Okay. Let's see. 12p square minus 9p plus 5 plus 4 minus 4p square plus 7p minus 10. Like terms means what? Same variable, same exponent. P square. Bring them together. PP, bring them together. And constant, bring them together. No constant, so keep it as it is. So 12 minus 4, 8. Okay. Then this 5 minus 9 minus 7, it becomes minus 11. Okay. Then 10 as it is. So 8p square plus minus, right? Minus 11p and 10. This minus 11p means 5 minus 9 is minus 14, right? Then minus 7. This minus 4 minus 7. Sorry, it was minus 14, minus 4 it was. Minus 4 minus 7, minus 11. So that is the answer. That is this problem you get for solving. Okay? So again I say follow the problems on the app. You'll get a better understanding. Subtraction of general algebraic expression. Same way, nothing, no difference. Bring like terms together and subtract it. Very simple. Either you can do it vertically or you can do it horizontally also. Okay, vertically we'll see that. See this. 4ab, 5b square and 3a square. And 5a square, 3b square minus ab. What is given? Just check the problem correctly. Subtract this from this. So this should be above. 5a square plus 3b square minus ab, this should be above. And this first one should be below. Okay. So while writing this, write below AB, B square below B square and 3A square below 3A square. Okay. So bring them along with sign. Now when you subtract it, what you do is keep one line spacing in between and then change the signs. This is minus, so make it plus, right? This was minus over here. So make it plus because you are subtracting. Then minus, make it plus. Here plus, make it minus. And now use the new signs for the lower terms. So minus AB, minus 4AB, right? So it becomes minus minus plus 4 plus 1, 5. Sign of the bigger one, that is 4, minus 4AB. Similarly, B square, 5B square plus 3B square, 8B square. Sign of the bigger one, the new sign is to be used, plus 8B square, right? Similarly for 8A square, okay? So that's it about subtraction. Finding the value of an expression, easiest part, totally, nothing different. If you want to know the value of an expression, then we easily find the numerical value of the given expression by inputting the value of the variable given, like see here. 2x plus 7, if I tell you, find the value of 2x plus 7, if x equals to 3, now x equals to 3, you know, just put the value of x, so it becomes 2 into 3 plus 7, so it becomes 6 plus 7, that is 13. Same logic, expressions with two or more variables means what? Same, it's a repeat. Y square plus 2yz plus z square. Find the value if y equals to 2 and z equals to 3. Just put the values. What? 2 square plus 2 into 3 plus 3 square, right? Put the values 4, 12, 9, add them, 25 is the answer. That's it. Nothing different, nothing brainy. Okay. Now the formula for various perimeter of a triangle, perimeter of a square, perimeter of regular pentagon. We have already covered everything in the respective chapters. Perimeter of equilateral triangle, 3 into side. Of square, 4 into side. Of regular pentagon, 5 into side. Area of square, a square means side square. then area of rectangle length into breadth, area of triangle half base height. These we have covered. That's why I am not wasting my and your time over here. Now rules for number pattern. Not that difficult, but just pay attention. If we denote a natural number n, then its successor will be n plus 1, right? Means natural number means 0 starting from 1. So n equals to 3, then successor is 3 plus 1, 4. Even this is true for whole numbers also. If I put 0 in place of n, then 0 plus 1 is 1. That's a successor. Okay. It's true for any, even I put it integer, it's the same. Right. Integer means what? Minus 5, minus 6, minus 7. If I add them, successor will be the next number. Minus 7 plus 1, minus 6. That's a successor. Right. If we denote a natural number, n, by n, then 2n will always be an even. That's very important. See this. And take a note of this. See this. Any number, let's say 3. So 2n will be what? 2 into 3, 6. It is always even. Anything multiplied by 2 will always be even. Suppose if I take 11, 11 to the 22, it's always even. And 2n plus 1 will always be odd. Suppose 2 into 3, 6 plus 1, 7, that's always an odd, right? So example is given over here. See this, n equals to 3, 2n equals to 6, even, 2n plus 1 equals to 7, odd, okay? If we arrange the multiples of 5 in ascending order, then we can denote it by 5n. See here, multiples of 5 means 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10, 5 3 is 15. That, these are the multiples of 5. So, if we check that, we will have the 11th term in this series. Then we can check it by 5n, putting n equals to 11. It's quite simple. Suppose if I ask you to find the 15th term in this series. So, what's the difficulty? 5 into n. 15th term means 5 into 15. 15 by the 75. That's it. So, even that, this is basically a table of 5. It can be a table of 7, 8, 9, 10, 100. Any table, okay? Pattern in geometry. Now, this is something new for you. See here, number of diagonals we can draw from one vertex of any polygon is n minus 3. Means what? Kindly understand it clearly. This is not the number of diagonals that can be drawn in the polygon. This is that the number of diagonals that can be drawn from one point, one vertex. Means what? Let's see an example. Okay, how many diagonals can be drawn from one vertex of an hexagon, of a hexagon? See this, hexagon. How many sides hexagon? It's not an hexagon. 3, 3, 6, and it's 8. Octagon it is. The example given is of octagon and written is hexagon. Okay, let's see this octagon. Okay, four sides here, octagon. Okay, from one vertex A, how many diagonals can I draw? What are diagonals? Diagonals are lines from any vertex to a vertex which is not adjacent to that vertex, right? So A to B is not a diagonal, but A to C is a diagonal. So how many diagonals can I draw? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, does it fit in this formula? N minus 3. Octagon has how many? 8. 8 minus 3, 5. So, 5 diagonals can be drawn. Now, consider the example of hexagon. 6. How many diagonals can be drawn from one vertex? 6 minus 3, 3. Okay, let's take an example. Square. How many sides does a square have? Square has 4 sides. So, how many diagonals can be drawn? 4 minus 3. That is 1. That is correct. Only one diagonal can be drawn from any point on a square. Right? Okay. So that's it. That was a theory on algebraic expressions. You can download Yuvaguru Maths Olympiad app from Play Store to get these theory lectures and solved problems. Solved problems are easy as well as difficult. All the problems are solved. You can get it from this Play Store app, and these are useful for CBSE, ICSE, various state boards across India and outside India also. So anyone who deals in maths should download this app. Follow us on Facebook on this link, WhatsApp us on this number for any query related to purchases. So keep studying, keep watching. Thanks.